Fireworks and music still going on?
The fireworks and the music is still going on.
Okay. Still no one's paying any attention.
Yeah, I'll pay no attention.
Then. And you just see that commotion within the crowd. What do you want to do?
I'm informing, I guess Dan was informing the guy that accompanied us, Sander.
Yeah, Sander to wake up. His brother. Yeah,
I'm heading towards that. Quick speed. Post haste.
So Melvin's going to this man.
Yeah.
Okay. What is it? He's kind of like in a drunken buzz stupor.
I'll just sort of point over at the well-dressed gentleman. That's frantic.
He says, go ahead, go prove yourself, he says.
And falls asleep again.
I'm
already halfway there.
So you see a violet firework going to the sky, kaboom. And as you get closer, the merchant, it's clearly that he's a merchant now, because he is near a cart with an insignia that matches his, there's an insignia on the cart that matches his
chest plate,
basically his chest plate.
Tunic.
What is the insignia of?
Looks like an ox, like the head of an ox, and it is outlined in white.
Is it something I would recognize from a book?
You can roll a history check.
That'll be intelligence. I've got 14 plus. I guess it's 15.
This is the Viking Vale Trading Company.
All right.
What are
they trading?
They're trading in fine clothes, fine silks.
I'll go up to him.
He's a merchant of the company, I should say.
I'll just ask, what's wrong?
He says, she was right here. Right here. She was beside me. My wife. Where is she?
When did you see her last?
Just a moment ago, when the fireworks went up in the sky. She was right there.
Perhaps she just walked off to do something.
Release herself,
perhaps.
Jenica, that's her name, Jenica. And he yells her name like really loud, and like, Jenica! And the crowd's looking at this crazy looking man. And what do you want to do?
I mean, this is perhaps too much into video games, but can I see any tracks leading off from the cart?
That's okay, because actually, within Dungeons & Dragons, a perception check is perfect for something like that. Or survival. Whatever your better,
Investigation perception. As well.
Yeah. You can request.
I have
11.
Alright, so you're investigating the area. How do you want to investigate? Are you like looking at the ground or?
Yeah, pretty much like if any tracks leave off, if anyone's just footprints or any kind of things like that.
Okay.
I guess the cart was dragged there and that leaves some tracks, but any tracks that leave off in a strange direction. like into the woods or perhaps or something.
Well, assuming that you have gone to the edge of the wildlands or in the edge of the forest where
they stand.
Yeah. You do see a little bit of blood trickled on the bushes.
Okay. I look into the bushes to see if there's anyone in there.
She had a nosebleed.
Or the time of the month.
Go ahead and roll another perception check.
Oh, God. You're a horrible person.
17.
Well, nothing of that sort, but you do see some tracks within a little bit of a... within the mud. There's some mud there, since this is along the coastline, and they don't look human.
What do they look like? Smaller, bigger?
But next to these weird-looking tracks are human tracks. Or I should say humanoid tracks. And they're all side by side. Clearly there's a struggle here. And you can go ahead and roll investigation.
As everything's kind of quieted down and people are kind of paying more attention to this, I'm going to break out of my kind of silent gaze and walk over.
Melvin, Roland, sorry.
You can roll as well. We're all there as a group, right?
I'm guessing so.
Probably. Oh, damn.
Brad,
kind of Brad's thing.
Yeah. I'm going to give everybody a chance to roll, actually. Go ahead.
Sherlock Holmes here.
I'm a spy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Minus one. Oh, yeah.
You are. Like.
Of course, my survival's minus one.
In the complete opposite direction, you're like, I think she went there, because no tracks. And that always shows that they're going in the way that no tracks are leading.
I'm just going to grab his shoulder and point a different direction.
Well, I think they went that way. So. I don't think you're right, but. I guess I'll follow the consensus.
The tracks are always trying to trick you.
Yeah, they're calling me names. I might be the fire y'all, but.
So at the edge of this forest, seeing specks of blood and maybe a sign of a scuffle, Brad immediately recognizes these tracks. They are the tracks of goblins.
Oh.
I'm gonna take out my shield and my warhammer.
Yeah, I'm gonna
at this point.
Draw my short sword and say these look like goblin tracks.
And the merchant, still panicking, like, have you found her? What's going on? What is it? Why are you going in the woods?
Calm down.
He says, what is it? To Mike.
Well, she wandered off into the woods. Probably some fairy lights in the distance. We'll just go get her real quick. It's okay. Just wait here.
I like this story better. So.
Just wait here. It'll be fine. We'll be right back. Don't worry.
You should go sit with Sander.
Dan, roll a charisma.
A persuasion?
Yeah. Go ahead, persuasion. And I'm going to do the same thing.
I think you muted yourself.
Go ahead and roll persuasion. Yep.
Persuasion.
I'm just going to roll up a d20.
Ooh.
He's unstable. Okay. Most
I'm
definitely,
good with persuasion.
You're able to calm him down a bit, and he sits down on a stump, and there's some people from the crowd, and it's like, what's wrong? What's wrong? And he tells his story, too. But it looks like you are all going into the woods to...
We're just going to leave him with the crowd.
Yeah, we'll just leave him with the crowd.
Yep.
I'm going to, like, use my boot to get rid of the blood.
Now, before we go further, I definitely do not want to railroad you, so, I mean, you can definitely do anything you want.
Yeah.
I go back to Sander and... No,
okay. Yeah. My character's not about letting just women get dragged off into the woods and killed, so...
Yeah.
I'm okay with this railroad.
My oath as a paladin doesn't even allow me to turn around and look away.
All right, then.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe she has some money or something.
we've all got our reasons to go.
That's Brad's reason.
And the other guys are going, so...
It's a merchant. He'll probably have money. He'll pay us.
Yeah. True that.
Oh, we should have established that. Oh, well.
Anyway, I'm going to start looking around and
see if I can see anything. Yeah. You were the one
who... Yeah, all walking into the forest.
Now, I'm going to take the Dawnforge cast method. I'm going to try this. And I'm going to have... I probably should do this in the beginning of the session. But I want everybody to roll a initiative.
14.
23. Natural 20.
And the tracker.
Ah, there we go.
Oh, wait, we have
hardly tractor. Oh,
we have to roll again to have those turn up.
Do we need to select our champion or character?
I can plug them in.
Did mine roll? Yeah, there it is. No, that's perception.
Yeah, we have to click on our token and then roll, and then it'll.
But my 23.
Fuck.
No, I mean that's fine for you, but if you're gonna try to roll with the in the pages app, you have to.
Hey,
have
I have 23 book. Now.
Oh.
I am the master commander.
Oops, wait, hold on.
Do we have a token on the board?
Bear with me there.
Reroll
again, guys.
Okay.
Okay.
Using the dice roller?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we need to not just select our...
Select, yeah. Oh, you want... Yeah, you need to see your tokens, don't you?
Yeah.
I can
token
grab
page.
My own. Okay.
All
right. Sure.
There we go.
Okay.
16, that's fine.
My apologies.
Why didn't it work?
Okay.
I got a natural 20 and I clicked on my token and it didn't work.
Aww.
I'm gonna try it again.
I can...
Oh, come on, I got a 19!
No, you have to roll it inside the sheet in order to get it to put it up over there like that.
Or use the macro that I had set up. If you click on your token, and you'll see it appear up top.
There it is.
I've clicked up on my token and initiative. Nope.
I have the initiative in Skype chat.
I must be doing something wrong. Physically click on your token, and then it gives all your 12, 18, 30, and your cogwheel and your shit, right?
Okay.
And then
And then use the dice roller, right?
No, go into the your character
you need to
sheet.
Have a tracker.
Oh, character sheet, character sheet.
And then click the initiative button.
I'm gonna get like
roll on initiative.
I'm gonna get 2 now. Watch.
Yep, that's exactly. What? Well done.
Well,
good job.
Well, iron that out in the future. Nice. But okay, yeah, we'll definitely just. Use the sheets next time.
Well, we know how to do it now, and we have the tokens, so...
Yeah. All right, so... Yeah, go back to Salters. We're just still doing Theater of the Mind here.
Yep.
Okay.
Hmm? Turn order disappeared.
Because we changed pages, I think.
Yeah, we have to have our tokens on the page, which we can drag in like that. Or just delete.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point.
So, within the woods, you're getting closer. The woods themselves and the under, you know, all the bushes and all the plants, they're kind of like tropical in nature. You know, like our world. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit of a tropical like to it. And there's a lot of roots coming out from the ground. I would say it's tough terrain if you go in further. And it starts to elevate up.
Are there any, like, firelights? Or, yeah.
Yeah, have we see any tracks or anything?
Or fires in the distance, lights in the distance?
Or any sounds?
Visibly, no.
Okay.
So the more you go out into the woods, it becomes dark. Not pitch dark, but dark.
Right. Alright.
But we still are following tracks that lead us this way.
I'm going to light the torch.
I do have dark vision.
I do as well, but I'm going to light a torch anyway.
For our human fellows?
Exactly.
Good thinking. So you do see, after lighting the torch, and maybe with the assistance of dark vision, you see that the tracks and the scuffling and maybe specks of blood lead further south, southwest within the wildlands, and you start to hear the wildlife around you become alive, you know, the chirping of birds, maybe some lizards, the sounds of lizards hissing and
the roaring of a T-Rex.
Yeah. Hey, don't get me started.
I've done that. I know you have the sound. I know you have the sound. Don't
I'll
even
bring out that T-Rex right now. Tail whip.
So I guess just keep following the tracks.
Nothing ominous about that.
What do you mean? This is
this is the totally soundtrack not to Aladdin.
This is totally not creepy.
Okay, so what do you want to do? I mean, you're just sitting there in the woods. Following the tracks. Great.
Follow the tracks.
And as you follow the tracks, you hear a scream far in the distance.
Follow the tracks even faster.
No, I don't think that's a good idea with the light.
We know the direction of the scream. Jamie?
It sounds like it's coming southwest.
Okay, I'm going to turn off the light and just start going in that direction.
And you start to hear a rustling in the bushes next to you.
It's a bunny!
No, I take out my shield and warhammer and just
get ready, boys. We're about to get in the thick of it.
Oh, I thought you were going to bash the bush.
I don't want to do that just in case there's a woman in there.
Yeah, I'll pull out my short sword. My rapier. And kind of look around.
I had mine out when we started.
I'm staring at the bush with pruning intentions.
The flicker of the torch just illuminates parts of the forest, and you see like a shaking within one of the tall bushes, tropical plants, and it's just shaking like very violently. And out comes a
bunny rabbit.
Lizard.
Bunny rabbit. Problem. A lizard.
And it has caught its prey. It looks like it's kind of like a mouse creature.
Oh, wait, it is. Oh, shit.
So, nothing to be alarmed about, I suppose. It just hisses and hisses back at you. And
ooh, I thought my number was on that one.
Perception check would have helped.
Well,
let's keep going.
Yeah.
So from here on out, you're all responsible for what you do.
All right, well, I'm putting out the torch because we know the direction of the scream.
Warn you, you can see in the dark.
What about the humans?
Lead the way.
Alright, well, I'll hand the torch to the humans, and I'll be at the front of the group away from the torch.
I mean, that's where I'm planning to be.
You should be ahead of us.
Yeah, let's talk about...
marching order.
Marching order.
Yeah. I'll lead us.
And I'll... actually, I'll be in the back of the group.
And back? I'll be...
yeah, the back. Because I can see... so if you two are in the middle, you guys don't have the best vision, but so that way we have dark vision in front and we have dark vision at the back.
Yeah.
Okay, so
I wanna call the herd.
Call the herd, yep.
Alright, I'm gonna roll a perception check and keep going forward.
Get along, great. Little darkness.
Sorry, yeah. I only have one screen, so...
I'll kind of hold my my hand on the person in front of me so that I can use them to judge where we're going.
I'm guessing I would perhaps stand in front of you, so... I'm feeling a creepy hand on my shoulder.
Well, we've got... Brad in front leading the group, and then... we're all following him. So if he messes up with leading us, we know who to blame.
And I'm staying just in the torchlight so they can see me.
And all of a sudden, in the woods, in the tree, you caught the eye of two goblins rushing up it. You have caught them by surprise because they were about ready to ambush you, but you caught them just in time. It looks like you have ambushed them.
How far apart are we?
1 second, guys.
How far are we from the goblins?
I think he's bringing up a map.
Yeah, he might be bringing up a map.
I think he's turning up music.
No, there's just like weird echo coming from it.
Hmm.
I'm getting a weird echo. Well, anyways, there's no map. And... you're about, let's say, 30 feet away from the tree where the goblins have scurried up. There's two of them.
We lost our initiative rolls.
Not on my screen.
Melvin was first, then it was me, then it was...
Well, if we go back to the token page, I think it'll show it to us. And since we're doing Theater of the Mind anyways...
might as well. That. Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Alright, so... I'm first?
Yeah, one
Looks
second.
Like
it.
Is that
one
right?
Second. One second.
Alright.
Hang in there.
Okay. No!
Yes! Do it now! Okay.
Don't make him bring a dinosaur out.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna be nice.
Okay, so now, it's Melvin first.
Yeah. And, okay, so I see two goblins. I can run up to one of them because I have 40 feet of movement. And I strike him with my quarterstaff. Is that a valid thing to do? I roll a 19 with 10 damage.
Oh, okay. Ten damage, and you did.
Is it dead?
Roll 19, and you hit him, and it looks like you did some mean damage, and it looks like you killed that nasty goblin, who had.
How far is the other? How far is the other goblin?
The other goblin is 30 feet up in the tree, and you just noticed that his buddy just went down.
So he's 30 feet more? They're
high.
30 feet apart from me?
Nope, actually.
Oh. So he's out of range.
You're at the base of the tree, and that goblin is 30 feet high.
And the other goblin was on the ground?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I look up at him and... Aw, I can't get you. And then I don't do anything else.
You do a casual backflip.
Yeah, I do a casual backflip. That is exactly what I do.
So,
trying to impress him.
Still within a surprise mode. Brad, you're up. What is Brad going to do?
Alright, let's see. In surprise mode, I get a movement and an action.
Yeah,
that's right.
So I'm going to use my movement to draw a dagger, and I'm going to toss the dagger at the goblin in the tree. I'm assuming I can see him.
Yes, you can.
Alright. Where to put the weapons?
I mean, I'm guessing that you can use a bonus action to draw the weapon and then move still.
I don't need to move anyway.
Drawing a weapon is now part of the attack action. It's an extra action you can take in the attack action.
Yeah, it's like a free action. Oh. Or not even a free action.
Yeah.
Yep, that hits right square in the neck. Ooh. And the goblin falls to the ground from the tree. And passes away. But not just like that. It starts to shake and rattle. There's still a little bit left in him. But you can just tell that one is done for.
Kick him while he's down.
Did they make a lot of noise?
No, this one fell down very silently. You got him right in the neck.
Really?
Yeah, right in his voice box.
Do we hear the screams of this woman from anywhere?
Yes, you do. You hear a very faint scream.
Moving away?
Yep, further in the southwest.
Time to run.
I want to quickly see if these goblins have anything on them.
Quickly.
Just very quickly.
Okay, you do see a sack. Looks like there's something inside of it. And
pick it up and
first one.
Move forward.
Thank you.
It's full of marbles.
Okay, Brad receives his dagger, and you found 2 silver pieces.
2 silver pieces?
Yep.
In that bag?
That brown, dirty, slimy bag that goblin had. And
alright.
Looks like there's another bag.
That's good.
Another bag.
On the one that Mike killed.
I guess as Mike retrieves his dagger, he takes that. Or what?
Do I need to roll anything?
No. Do you want to look inside of it?
Yeah, I'll look inside of it. I wouldn't probably check it for traps.
It explodes.
Yeah.
Noxious fumes.
It's a thunderstorm. There's thunderstorm.
You find a trinket.
Ah, damn it. I got the worst.
And I'm going to allow you to roll.
I like this DM.
Yeah. 2 goblins in and a trinket.
Well, I love the trinket table because you can create a whole story from just one item.
Yeah, that's true.
13.
You need to roll a D100.
Oh, sorry. I thought it was 20.
Right? It's a 100 chart, I think.
If it's the trinket chart, yeah. 40.
Just real quickly, what page was that?
I am going to it right now. It's with the backgrounds.
Oh, okay. Backgrounds. Thank you so much.
It is page 160.
160. And he rolled a 40. Okay, cool.
Yep.
So he got, thank you, by the way, a 60.
No problem.
You found a glass eye.
Mm. Now he rolled a 40.
Interesting.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm gonna say glass eye anyway.
Okay.
Okay.
That's why they didn't spot us. One of them didn't have 2 eyes.
Yeah. There you have it.
Is it clean?
scratched up.
I guess I'll stick it in my pouch. My coin pouch.
I say, you guys, we need to move forward. You hear the screaming lady, we need to fulfill our mission.
Yes, much haste.
I gotta keep an eye on my other screen here. That's where I'm recording from. All right. Keep on going forward. Excellent. And you hear screaming.
Perception checks.
But as you keep on going further in the woods, you come to this area. You haven't encountered anything, but there's got to be at least 1 mile within the woods. Oh, wait a minute. Shit.
I was going to let you know.
I don't see anything. I have turned off my screen.
You have not shadowed those areas yet.
I do not look at that screen right now.
There's boxes over it. I can't see anything.
Yeah, all I see is this green grass down here that I've totally scrolled down to.
That's a nice...
Yeah. I mean, that's some beautiful green grass.
Look at that boulder.
That damn boulder. Ooh, there's a character on that screen as well.
Ah, oh. Everything's darkness now.
that's one way to make the fog. Let's just fog everything.
How do you get rid of the deck, by the way?
Also wondering that. I accidentally put forward that like a week ago, and then it's still there.
So I think you're trying to click... Oh, there we go. I saw like little lines, but now I can see the grass.
This is... And I guess we can drag in our avatars?
Yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah, I can just copy-paste them over.
Oh, yeah. You want to do that too.
We got it. Oh, wait.
Either way goes.
Mine don't... If you copy and paste, they will have the stats in them, but these characters won't.
Yeah, so that's why I probably...
Okay. Yeah.
Here they come. Here they come. Okay. And transporting. Boom.
Yeah.
Whoa. Hello.
That.
So, marching order.
And Cyrus is dead.
He doesn't even exist.
Oh, yeah. That was the marching order we had before. So.
Yeah, my guy.
Assume I'm still in lead.
My face is just Brad.
Yeah, the turn order is not showing up. That's right. That's weird.
Shall we roll turn order?
It's a new turn order?
Yeah. Wait, hold on, though. Hold on. Let me... it's actually broken.
You can have that.
On my end. Oh, wait a minute. No, it's not. Okay, remove all
if
turns.
If we just...
Go ahead.
If we just roll new turns.
Yep.
Haha!
Oh, that's a very... Yeah, totally.
Why?
I mean, you're just looking at the beautiful flowers and the roots and the trees.
Hey, guys.
You're out.
Natural one.
I think the woman left the other way.
you're still convinced that it's the other way.
Yeah, that's why I'm looking back that way.
I'm just gonna shake my head like he's hopeless.
I know, but he's such a sweetheart, or whatever.
I see a silver bar over here.
Yep, that I've is given. Steel, twin steel doors.
Are they?
That's random for being out here.
Well, see, You have come to an area where it starts to open up within the woods, and it looks like the entrance to a cave of some sort. It looks like it was kind of, it's slightly, not, it's not hidden, but you can tell it's embedded within a hill. Or whatever is behind this door is embedded within a large hill. And before you, you know, there's a large mound. That doesn't make sense.
Sure.
It's like the roaring hills of the Shire, but there's a big metal door.
You guys are right here, the circle. See? Circle. And steel door. And blocking your path is this big mound encircling the area.
Right, and the steel door is in front of us.
Yep.
Okay.
Alright, well, let's knock politely on the door.
Let's check to see if it's locked first.
Check for traps?
No, that'd probably be a good idea, too.
But being the thief and all. Or spy. What did you tell... What have you told us that you are?
Oh, actually, I didn't tell you guys what I was. I just said I was a former nobleman, didn't I?
Yeah, I mean, I guess during our 19-day voyage, have you not revealed anything about yourself?
No, I probably would not have revealed that I'm a spy, because I'm on the run, so...
But you seem very perceptive, and that could be helpful when looking for traps.
You guys could. And I could tell you I'm a thief, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, and you were also
explain
hiding.
Why I'm on the run.
Yeah, you were hiding in this ship, on this ship, which was also kind of curious, interesting, strange.
I would like to check the door to see if it's locked or has any traps, and I probably don't see anything.
Door's
wide
open.
It's wide open.
It's only... goblins,
well,
you think.
Let's send Vorn in first.
I mean, there is a T-Rex inside, you know.
Right, leave it to me. Leave it to me. I'll sort this out. Hello?
Do we,
I just facepalm.
Let's not send the half-wit in first.
I don't do that. I don't do
that. Okay. Then I don't facepalm.
What do you all want to do? We'll start with Brad. And Brad did check out the door. See if it was locked. And just visibly looking at it, coming before these two steel doors, that there is a keyhole.
I'm going to ask these guys what they want to do.
Do we hear any sounds from inside, such as the woman screaming?
No.
Nothing.
Nothing.
I would think we'd heard her before they brought her in there, if they brought her in there.
This is the direction we heard the screams, though. Okay.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
What if we put the glass eye into the keyhole? That sounds like it would work, right? I said we could try it.
Well, first, we could just try and... open the door without trying to unlock it if it isn't locked.
With an eye. That might work better. How tall is Melvin?
Jeez. American measurements. I'd say he's about
whatever 66 meters is in feet.
I'll stand regardless, I'll stand behind him.
In feet, like 5'9", perhaps.
About the same size as me, then.
I'm exactly 6 foot, too. 6 foot, just 6 foot, not 6 foot, too.
I guess, looking, I would go and, if nobody takes the initiative, I would go and try and open the door. Try the handle. If there's a handle. Is there a handle?
There are. Yeah, on each door there's a handle.
try one, and if that doesn't work, the other.
Okay, so you're wiggling with the handle. It's firm. It's not turning. So it would be safe to say it is locked.
I can try and pick it.
You don't have any lock picking tools, do you?
I actually do have supposed to have a lock picking kit.
Oh, then be my guest, please.
All right, I will try to do that. Let me get back on the right page here.
I'll try and put my ear towards the door, like against the door, to see if I can hear anything, as though someone's talking on the other side or something like that. Should I make a perception check?
You can. Yeah, go ahead. No, I would do a. Perception is like seeing the world around you, something that relates to senses.
Well, perception would be that.
I would say perception relates to that as well.
Go ahead. Yeah.
Be able to hear something.
Yeah.
Jesus.
You put your ear upon the steel door, and
it's cold.
Yeah, you feel coldness and maybe like the vibrations of, you know, the forest kind of playing through the steel doors. But other than that, you don't hear anything.
All right. Then I would gesture to Brad that it's time to try and open the door.
But you feel a thump upon the door.
Like someone's on the other side knocking on it. Or...
a thump and a scratching sound.
Okay, I'm saying to Brad...
It really is a T-Rex.
I wouldn't like that. Please open the door quickly. It could be the woman.
I will try. It's a sleight of hand for that, right? For lockpicking?
Yeah.
I'm going to stand by the door with my shield protecting Brad.
Actually, with lockpicking, you can do, I think you have thieves' tools. So,
using thieves' tools gives him advantage, I think?
Yeah, I think it just gives him advantage.
So you can roll again.
Yeah, I mean, if it works better for you.
Roll again. Sweet.
So you just want me to roll a dexterity check?
New sleight of hand.
Yeah, you can just roll sleight of hand again. So it's an advantage.
Actually, it'd be the exact same thing.
10.
Wow!
Yeah, it's 10.
Okay. Well, what do we do?
I mean, any of us can do it. It's just that the...
what happens?
The tool pick makes it easier.
Yeah. And you feel the key going in... But a key.
Maybe I should try the eye.
The tool picks.
Tool picks. And it doesn't unlock the door.
Now, can I tell at all, is it an actual key? Like a lock that is holding the door in place? Or like a wooden bar on the other side?
It is a... it's a lock, and there's a keyhole.
Okay.
Yeah.
Warren, that idea about the glass eye, let's just try that.
Hang on just a minute. I might have said that when I was a bit tipsy. Wait, does it look like an eye, the keyhole?
Could the eye fit into the keyhole somehow?
And I mean, I can take it out and try to shove it in. This lock's never going to open.
You can't even turn it. It just, like, goes into place.
It actually blocks the hole so that we can't actually pick the lock now.
I think I'll try and pick the lock.
And the girl is dead.
Let me try picking the lock.
Aren't any of you guys the strong fighting type?
That would be me, but I don't know if I could shake the luck loose.
You already won a fight or an arm wrestling match, so
that's true.
A door wouldn't be much difference.
I mean, it's metal.
Oh, well, the lock doesn't mean it's got to be metal. Could be just wood. Some stupid goblins in the woods. You think they got metal locks?
Right. Sound logic to me. Strength check. Here we go. No.
Hey, if it's a good strength check.
No, don't you get advantage on that?
That is not a good strength check.
No, I don't get advantage on that.
And
who's the weakest person?
I mean, that's a... You basically knocked on the door, so perhaps someone answers.
Yeah, if we make enough noise, they might come to us.
Wait. I got a brilliant idea. I have a brilliant idea. Is there any space for me to tuck my war pick in, or the pick side of my warhammer and use it as a crowbar?
You can give it a try.
How would I give it a try?
A strength check?
With advantage?
Athletics or strength?
Okay, so you're putting the edge. Okay, so I'm going to say dexterity.
Okay.
So you're just trying to work the edge of your weapon kind of within the crevice of the, or in between the two doors.
Right, okay. So just a base dexterity check?
It looks like this might be a hard feat, though.
Right, got it.
A credit card?
What's that?
A plus zero dexterity. Here we go.
A card of credit.
Well,
No, but a piece of your weapon starts to chip away.
Oh, good. I'm going to pull that out.
Just a small little part. But all of a sudden, an arrow flies towards you.
From outside or inside?
From outside, from behind.
I don't. Yeah, I don't think it could hit me from the door.
And it bounces off the door. Bounces off the door, and then another one seems to fly out from behind all of you. I would say you're all positioned where you are.
I'm at the door, right? So.
Okay, and William is going to be the receiving and does that hit you?
That will hit me,
and that's going to be
probably more than I like.
70 damage.
Even 7 damage would be a lot.
That's even more 8
would be a lot too.
That's the maximum damage. So
someone poked you with the pointy end.
Oh, actually stabs me with something, not an arrow?
It's an arrow.
Oh, it is an arrow.
I was just trying to make a joke. Someone hits you with the stabby end, with the pointy end.
Yeah, real pointy end.
Game of Thrones reference.
Hey, we should probably deal with this.
You say who's profusely bleeding?
I look back and see, look at if I can see Cyrus dead in the woods or something.
What? Oh.
Can we see who's attacking us?
If I have a chance, I'd like to cast Cure Wounds on myself.
Is it initiative?
Yeah, should we roll initiative
or
again?
Or are we keeping initiative? What do we want to do there?
I assume this was...
This is the initiative. We haven't played with these.
Right, yeah, so...
Damn it.
So right now you do not know where this has come from. But you know generally it...
Come from this area. Burn the forest down.
From where?
And what is everybody's passive perception?
We don't see where you said it came from.
Oh.
It must be in the...
It might be in the Fog of War.
Fog of War.
Oh, yep.
Or perhaps we have zoomed in.
Oh, it's not showing up. That's weird. Maybe I'm on the wrong layer. Yep, I'm on the wrong layer. Okay.
Okay.
Alright. So next to William. Oh, from two sides?
Yep.
Okay.
What is everybody's passive perception?
Where does it show it on the sheet?
It's just 10 plus a modifier, right? All right.
Yeah, it is 10 plus. If you're proficient plus 2, then plus 3, or plus your wisdom.
That's persuasion.
So that would be 15. My passive perception is 15.
Perception, the numbers are on the right side in the sheet.
Whoops, I hit persuasion.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Oh. Oh, no, passive perception. Okay, so I have 12.
I have 15. I just can't find where it is.
It's to the, under perception, it's to the right.
The number to the right of the perception.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, Well, anyway, 15. Would I see anything with 15? I think I have the highest.
Indeed. Not only did William Tucker notice this goblin archer. Oh, I'm still in the fucking wrong layer. Okay. Mm-hmm. Not only does he see that goblin 30 feet high in the tree, but. Melvin notices another archer. Come on.
Where? On the right side?
He's pulling it in.
Yeah. Oh, it's 30 feet. In the 30 feet away?
Mm-hmm. 30 Let's feet see. Away, and they have dropped down into the ground.
Both of them?
Yes.
That would be 40 feet from me.
Yep.
Brad is
there's
first
also on. This one.
And emerging out of the woods behind them are two others. And they have a very wide grin and sharp teeth.
Two more? I see only... Oh, yeah, there is.
This one here... Oops, you can't see it again. This one here says, "Lots to them!"
Is this one... Is that one up in the tree?
No, they both. He said they both dropped down, right?
Yeah.
Both dropped down?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's Brad first. Unless it's the goblins.
Do they get a? They've already had a surprise round, haven't they?
Yeah, but now I gotta roll. What's it called? Initiative for them.
Zero. That sounds good.
Good initiatives.
Yeah, I like it.
Oh my god. Oh, that actually just happened.
Oh, oh wait. Arches.
No, what? What happened here?
That's so weird.
That should be 17.
Hold on, I'm just gonna roll here. Okay, this is for the archers. So, 6.
Oh, thank god.
This is gonna be for the swordsman. Whoa, okay.
Ooh, damn. That's a crit.
You cheat, Dr. Ooh. Jones. Sending order. I think we're okay. So let me do one more thing real quick. If I may. Okay. So Goblin Swordsman is going to start the all the rounds. For every round, and Goblin Swordsman starts rushing up towards Brad. Unsheathes its scimitar and takes a big slice to your chest. And I'm rolling that right now. So get back into the groove of this. Okay, here we go.
16.
Yeah, that hits.
Okay.
The damage wasn't 6. Okay.
God damn.
Holy moly.
I'm dead.
We're all right, guy. You're not dead.
Not yet.
You're dead?
Oh.
Yeah. You're like, I had 5 health. What?
And,
did you change my health? Okay, you did.
This swordsman here rushes up 20, 25, rushes up to William.
Oh boy.
We'll be fine. Don't forget I have healing too.
Yeah.
That'll be useful when I'm on the floor.
Yeah, exactly.
So William only has like 1 hit point.
Actually, it's actually 1 hit point, yes.
10. That should miss you.
That does miss me, though.
Yay.
Luck is on my side. Except for the fact that I'm still in threatening range, so... Yeah.
So now the decision. Attack or heal?
That's not a decision.
Run away or die.
He gets an opportunity attack if he runs away.
Run away and die.
There you go.
Right, kill that guy. Stab him in the heart.
Yeah,
Brad's turn, yeah.
Sorry. Totally blanking. Okay. Health it. I'll just try to kill him. What's the worst that can happen?
He doesn't
die. Don't answer that.
You hit yourself.
We're not doing fumble tables, right?
I'm hoping not.
There you go.
15?
Yep, that's a hit.
And 6 damage? Oh, I didn't have the thing selected.
Do you get anything else for your turn?
I'm gonna shift back 5 feet.
In this version, you take attacks of opportunity if you move out of people's threatened squares.
Okay, whatever. I'll stay right where I am. I can roll a stealth check, though, can't I? Nah, that probably wouldn't work.
Not in the open...
Not standing directly in front of him.
It's
nighttime.
Take your cloak and like, you can't see me. I can't see you. You can't see me.
Invisibility. I'm Harry Potter.
Yeah. All right. Is it my turn?
I'll end my turn.
Okay. Yes, it's your turn, Melvin.
All right. Let's see. On that square, how much is this? 25. And that would be 20. If I run there, 20. There. Okay. So I...
You probably don't want to run exactly like that, though.
Why not?
Because you'll run through his threatened squares.
So he gets an opportunity attack.
But if you run this, and then this...
Yeah.
You can make it...
My thought is, run here... Hit this guy in the face, he dies, then run there, hit that guy in the face.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sure, that's an option.
You can do that. He's a monk.
I'll go here.
It's gonna really suck if you don't kill the first guy.
Or I just hit him twice. That doesn't matter.
That's true. Okay.
Yeah. So I run up to him, and I slam my quarterstaff in his face, and I pummel.
Ooh.
Ouch.
That is a miss.
Yeah, then I punch him in the face instead.
Right. Oh, and that definitely is a big hit. And how do you want to roleplay that?
Because
he's dead.
I guess I try to swing my quarterstaff, it misses, and then I just make a spin and backdrop kick him in the head.
Excellent. And do you want
to
end your turn on that?
Morph doesn't have anybody to kill.
Because I think you can still move.
Yeah, you can move that 10 feet if you want to just move next to the guy.
I can move 20 feet.
Oh.
I'm a monk. I've got 40 feet movement.
Right. Okay. Well, you can move next to the other guy if you want to do that, or move to one of the archers or something.
Yeah, I guess I'll move. I'll move up. Close to this archer.
Okay, very good. Alright, William.
Yeah, so...
Wallace.
I'm going to cast Cure Wounds.
Wise decision.
On
the goblin in front of you.
That's fine. It's okay. Forget how you do this.
Select yourself and then.
Oh. Ah, that's right.
Ooh.
Oh, that's weird.
Nine.
Nice.
That attack shouldn't be in there. But I'll heal myself for nine, so that's good.
Versus your AC. Does it come through your armor?
Okay, so I'm at full health now. That's good.
That's great.
Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and use my bonus action to inspire you guys. Who hasn't gone? Warren? All right. So I'm gonna play a little ditty for you and tell you, got this guy off me here.
I'll get right to it, boss.
And you can have a bardic inspiration.
Oh yeah, it's a D6.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
To any roll except damage.
Yep. Goblin Archer's turn.
Okay, and so they take the one next to Melvin drops his hold on one second, short bow, and pulls out a dagger.
Ah.
And that ends. That one ends its turn.
Oop, it's not gonna attack.
Nope, because it just dropped and then unsheathed, so that counts as an action. Far as I understand that, anyway.
Well, yeah, because he has to. Well,
dropping a weapon is free action.
Yeah, he can drop the weapon as a free and draw the sword as part of his attack if he wants to.
Your decision, Jamie.
That I encourage that you hit people.
Yeah, I'm gonna just leave it for that battle anyway.
Okay.
And this archer here takes aim at Melvin.
Thank God.
Oh. Me? What have I done?
That guy is a sniper.
And draws its. It smiles like. And then. Yeah, hold on.
Can he shoot without a disadvantage at 50 feet?
Yeah. Yes, he can.
Just pointing out. Okay.
Oh yeah, that would be a disadvantage. Well,
would it?
I'm gonna. A disadvantage. And
I thought the ranges on bows were a lot larger than that.
And for this one, it's 80 for minimum anyway.
Oh yeah, I forgot there's minimum. Wait, no.
No, that's, yeah, that means that it's, if it's within that 80 feet, it should be fine.
Yeah, it's if a target is within 5 feet of you, you get disadvantage.
But that misses me anyway, so.
Yeah.
Both rolls miss me. Got that 16 AC, bro.
Thorn! You're lucky this time.
He wakes up at the door.
We don't want to fumble. Shouldn't he lose a turn?
No.
running for this little lovely goblin in front of William, and I'm gonna whap him on the head.
Doing as the boss commands.
Oh yeah. Hang on, and Warhammer whapping.
Now you can add a D6 to that.
I am absolutely adding a D6 to my roll.
Hold on a second.
Slash roll D6.
Yeah. You can use a D6 on that. So, just roll a D6 and add it to your damage. Or your attack, I should say.
Yeah,
14.
14?
14 to do 7 damage.
That is a hit.
Nice.
7 damage? Oh boy. How do you want to roll
for that? Inspiration worked.
I want to impale my the hammer part of my Warhammer into his ear and then just pull it out with it.
Boom! Shaka-laka-laka. And it is down for the count.
And then, kind of as like a little bonusy thing, I just want to set up my shield protecting William.
Great. And the swordsmen are down, so we can say fuck you. And Brad, seeing that your buddy has completed it, has eviscerated one of the goblins, the last of the swordsmen within the area, you notice that Melvin is entangled with one of the bowmen, or the bow goblins. What will you do?
I'm going to move to right here, and then I'm going to cast a stealth. Roll of stealth.
Okay, you can do that. Kind of hiding into the tree line?
Yeah.
Okay.
See if I can't sneak up on him if I get a chance.
Sure. Definitely can do
I
that.
I really think he'll survive that long.
Okay, you're definitely hidden. Bowman, now I'm very distracted anyway with Melvin, so...
Okay, and I think that's it.
Okay.
Alright. I look at the goblin snarling into my face and say, oh, you don't have a lucky day today. As I whack him with my quarterstaff square in his face.
Seems to be a little bit lucky.
Damn it. Does an 8 miss? I'm guessing so.
That's a miss.
And... I repeat my cool miss with the quarterstaff and backdrop kick into the face.
Same rolls.
Yeah. Maybe he needs a different weapon.
Maybe he needs to always kick them.
Yeah. That's my
monks
move.
Monks have a really good unarm.
I attack with my quarterstaff and then I backdrop kick them in the face. That's my move.
And your dropkick sent him prone to the floor. Or to the ground.
Alright.
But not
that's
dead.
Not dead.
That's my move. Or my turn.
Alright. William, what shall you do?
It's me now, again.
Now you can't see you're noticing that one of your party members has kind of vanished.
That's fine.
Where did he go?
He's got it covered. He knows what he's doing. We're gonna go ahead and
no, I can't see me.
He disappeared. All entirely.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and cast Vicious Mockery on the archer that's in the forests over there. So he needs to make me a wisdom save.
Okay. No pluses there. Minus one.
Oh, good roll though. So nothing happens. I taunt him and I say, he's so weak. And he just doesn't seem to react to it.
And the goblin says,
I know.
That's not what your mother said last night.
And I'm
That's
going
not
to.
That's what your mother said last night.
And you take the damage instead.
Well, I'm just gonna move a little bit more behind Vorn, as I know that he's not as scared of me, and he has sniped me for 8 damage once.
Yeah. That's why I've got.
You know, Vor's not that tall, though. He won't provide much cover.
Yeah, that's
it's a tall Vor.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean you're tall.
True.
He tries, all right? That's the important part.
Maybe he's jumping up and down.
Yeah. I found a box to stand on.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's it for me.
Okay. So,
what you gonna do?
This one is gonna stab Melvin. Attempt to jump up on Melvin and not knock him down or anything. But that's gonna expend all of his movement, my discretion. But that goblin is gonna come from prone to jumping in the air, and Ooh. Basically trying to stab Melvin. Like, so here we go.
Give your best shot.
Natural 20.
Oh. My AC is 16, so that hits.
Yep.
Okay, so...
And Vorn is fine.
Max 6 damage. Ouch. Why can't I select my...
I did it.
There we go. Alright.
Usually you just click on your token and you just put like a minus 6 and then it'll auto-calculate.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Just in case you didn't know. And okay, we had one more archer. This one appears out of the woods. You already saw him. He was kind of like waist deep within the bush. Now he comes out in the clearing. 10, 15.
Rushing in.
Takes an aim at Vorn.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. Ooh, that's so close, but no cigar.
No. Oh. Very nice.
I just bash the arrow away with my shield.
Goblin gets frustrated very easily. And I think I can use a free action, and he drops his bow. And that's it.
Alright.
Alright, I'm going to run up to this guy, dropping my shield and sword, and try and tackle him down to the ground. You know, like, trying to keep him alive and just grapple him.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, and here's another thing, too, is if I, like, say, you know, you could, basically that hit killed him or is about to kill him, you can definitely choose to say that you want to keep him alive or stable.
Okay. Now I'm just going to grapple him.
Okay.
Because I'm pretty sure Melvin's about to take care of the other one. So,
yeah, you never know.
You never know, but that's what Vorn thinks.
I think it's athletics or acrobatics against...
I think it's athletics. Oh, no, it's my... is it my strength versus his strength? I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's your athletics versus his choice of acrobatics or athletics.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Yeah. So you can either try and dodge away or try to muscle away.
Okay.
Ooh, that's not great.
Yeah.
That's with a plus 5 as well.
The goblin's gonna try to squirm away from this one.
Yeah, oh, he God. Squirms away.
Slippery little bugger.
All right.
What are you trying to do? Humans.
My AC is now 16, by the way. Because I dropped my shield. Mm-hmm. I'll keep a mental track of that.
Okay. Yeah, just keep mental track of that, will you?
Yeah.
Brad.
Yeah, Brad's turn.
Brad! What you gonna do, boy?
I'm gonna sneak up here. Bro? Behind him. And reverse the grip of my sword and try to knock him out.
Now, I'm going to give you a GM tip. I'm going to move your token. If you moved him right here, like so...
he get flanking.
Flanking. Which is advantage.
But wouldn't that be moving... I'd have you taken more than 5 feet through his threatened range, wouldn't I?
Oh, okay. You're stealth. You're stealth, though.
Yeah,
I am stealth, too. Okay.
Also, right.
That's still within 5 feet, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, also in 5e, you can move like this all the way around someone, and it doesn't matter, as long as you're still staying, it's the second you move out of their 5 foot threat range.
Okay.
Plus, he's not holding a weapon right now.
He's holding a dagger.
I don't even think he even pulled that out.
Oh, okay.
No.
Okay, let me see here.
Yep, Brad's still and still.
I'm trying not to kill him.
I mean, okay.
And since that doesn't work because I can't see the roll.
It's 11. Probably not.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Does 11 hit?
No.
He has advantage though, right?
Yeah.
So you can roll that again. Just for the AC, against the AC.
Doesn't he have advantage for stealth as well?
I have,
Yeah, so...
That's his sneak
attack. Yeah, so he didn't even need the flanking.
No.
To get advantage.
I'll put you back where you were anyway.
But, oh, that's even worse.
Yeah, even worse.
The damage is good on this.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe I should have used the pony end.
Yeah.
Alright.
You did say the blunt end.
I did say the... I was going to smack him in the back of the head.
Each of you feel a feeling coming upon you, like a fuzzy feeling. You don't know where it's coming from. Maybe it's the woods. You just don't know, but you feel inspired. You feel something overcoming you with great confidence. Each of you got a point of inspiration.
Oh.
Hmm. Interesting. This is my turn? Or are you doing anything?
I'll end it. I'll hold off on using my inspiration.
I do my signature move of quarterstaff in the face. That misses, and then a backdrop kick.
What's that quarterstaff?
It hits.
Might as well just do unarmed strikes for now on.
Yeah, maybe I should do that. Less damage, but they at least hit.
Question is, did it? Yes, did it?
19?
I'm gonna hope a 19 hits.
You guys think it hits?
What?
Do you guys think it hits?
I think it hits.
I'm gonna vote that it did. Yeah.
I think for
it
yes. Hits.
Yeah.
And it turns into a T-Rex.
And all of a sudden he morphs into
Godzilla.
A giant
T-Rex.
No, I'm just kidding. This guy is down for the count. Do you want to kill him?
Yeah, I mean, the same thing. I intentionally miss my quarterstaff attack and then make a bolt, backdrop kicking him straight in the face.
It's funny because he's done that so many times.
Well, I'm going to... Your killing blow actually sends him flying backwards. Where did you get this power from?
Walmart.
Walmart.
Dun, 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 dun. An everyday low price.
Master Zhu has taught me this. Always miss for the first attack. That's...
Alright.
I forgot about that.
I'm gonna say, sick of this. And I'll run up and pull out my rapier and stab it at this guy here.
Oh no, he's dead. Or maybe he's not.
I would hope he's dead.
I'm pretty sure he said stab.
Or maybe he's not. Mental note. Maybe he's dead.
I stab him and I
cut off his head.
I intentionally let him live as he falls to the ground so we can get some information out of him.
Strike him straight in the head and like, don't you die! Don't you dare
he's
die!
He's missing an arm now, so...
Do they even speak common?
He did. He was mocking us.
Yeah. Human, or dwarves.
I was just gonna throw his face into the door and be like, open it. I think he'll get the picture eventually.
That's it for me.
It's the dead archer's turn, or unconscious, or whatever archer's turn.
Well, let's hold off for that for just 1 second. Bio break.
All right.
If you guys want to, I gotta go. Real
bad. I can go. I can do a bio break as well.
I will be right back.
Excellent. Is it getting late for many of you?
It's 5 to 5 a.m. so it's early.
Well, good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Time to make the coffee.
Actually, go to Walmart. Kind of is. No Walmart's in Sweden, but IKEA's.
I'm just casually on a brewing website.
What? All right.
Brewing kits that you totally have.
I have a local brewery store in the area.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
A
I'm gonna go fire break as well.
Stop. Recording.